Hello everyone, in this video we have one square and one triangle, and then here this length is given 4 and here this length is given 6, and then this angle is given 45 degrees and x is asked. Okay. First of all, let's call here y unit, and you know that the square has 4 same sides, so these are must be equal y, right? And these angles must be equal 90 degrees. Right. And then, if you notice that, these two lengths are equal, right? And ratio of these two angles equal 2. That means if we draw a circle like this, let's call here O. O is center of the circle, and let's connect here. That means Y must be equal radius of the circle. Right? Okay. And then notice that if the radius is perpendicular to the line, like this, that means circle must be tangent to the line, right? Therefore, if we apply tangent second theorem, so square of this length, x plus y whole squared equal first part 6 times second part is 10, right? So if we square root both sides of the equation, so x plus y must be equal root 60 and x plus y equal to root 15. So y equal to root 15 minus x. Okay, that's right here, y equal to root 15 minus x. And here is also to root 15 minus x, right? And then for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of x, right? So x squared plus 2 root 15 minus x whole squared equal 6 squared. Therefore, x squared plus 60 minus 4x root 15 plus x squared equal 36. And then x squared, 2x squared, minus 4x root 15, plus 60 minus 36 equal 0. So 2x squared minus 4x root 15, plus 24 equals 0. And if we divide by 2 both sides of the equation, therefore, we get x squared minus 2x root 15 plus 12 equals 0, right? Okay. And then, if we convert this expression to a perfect square, so x minus root 15 whole squared minus 15 plus 12 equals 0. X minus root 15 whole squared equal 3. So let's square root both sides of the equation. That means we have two scenarios, right? First one, x minus root 15 equal root 3. So x must be equal root 15 plus root 3, And second one, x minus root 15 equal minus root 3. So x is going to be root 15 minus root 3. Okay. Notice that both roots are greater than 0, right? So which one is true? How do you know this? So let's return the question and let's connect these two corners. We know that these are 45 degrees, right? Because of diagonal. And notice that this angle is an obtuse angle, right? Why? Because this central angle equal to sum of these angles, right? So alpha greater than 90 degrees. That means if there's a Fourier net opposite of the alpha, opposite of this acute angle here must be less than 4 units. So 2 root 15 minus x must be less than 4 units. Therefore, 2 root 15 minus 4 must be less than x. 2 times, we know that the square root of 15 is approximately 3 minus 4 less than x. Therefore, x can't take this value, right? So x is going to be root 15 plus root 3. Okay, thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.